Typically, for cloud droplets to go, they need a small, tiny seed particle to get that condensation of the water started. And so most people haven't thought of pollen as being a good starter for cloud droplets because generally they're too large and they don't last in the atmosphere that long. But what we found is when pollen gets wet, it can rupture very easily and make lots of small, tiny particles that can act as good seeds for clouds. When we think about the life cycle of pollen, the tree emits pollen to try to transmit its genetic material. So it emits these huge amounts of pollen grains with the small chance that one of those grains might land on a tree somewhere else. Okay, so it's actually a pretty inefficient system from the tree's perspective. So a lot of that pollen ends up around the tree, it ends up in the atmosphere, it might be transported distances from maybe one to several, or potentially even hundreds of kilometers. Our question is really focused on what happens to the rest of that pollen that ends up in the atmosphere before it makes it to its potential target, and also before it ends up influencing humans with seasonal allergies. We took particles and we put them in what we call a cloud condensation nuclei chamber, which means that we test to see whether or not the particles could act like a good CCN if they were in the atmosphere. So a cloud condensation nuclei is a small seed particle that acts as a collector for water in the atmosphere. They can be natural sources, like for example what we're talking about today, which is pollen, or they can also be anthropogenic or caused by humans from different types of pollution. Clouds are important because they're making the precipitation, and the response of precipitation under future climate warming is still very location dependent. So in some regions you might see an increase in precipitation, and in other regions you see a decrease. One of the things that we're trying to understand is how pollen can influence clouds and precipitation under present day and in future climate. In terms of trying to understand what's going to happen for future climate, understanding all these different compounds that we put in the atmosphere is very important. So most people are concerned with greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and methane. They're very important for absorbing infrared radiation. But one of the biggest uncertainties in this system right now is understanding how aerosols and the pollen as a natural aerosol impact clouds. It's pretty well known that individual trees can put out millions of pollen grains. And when we do pollen counts in the atmosphere, they're usually on the order of thousands during pollen season. A lot of times after thunderstorms, there's a huge rush in the emergency room for allergic responses. And so people have called that thunderstorm asthma. And so there have been a lot of theories about why these types of events happen. And one of them has been that in some way, the thunderstorms are triggering this rupture of pollen, and that makes it more respirable, and that's why you see more of a response. There's still no clear evidence for that, but some of those thoughts had us thinking about what that would mean for other for atmospheric systems, not just from the human health perspective. And so one of the things that we're thinking is that this could be important in specific regions, for example, in the northern mid-latitudes where we have a lot of these trees that put out wind-driven pollen, and also specifically at certain times of year. It's not going to be important everywhere at every single time, but during pollen season, we do think that in some regions it could be contributing to the overall number of small particles in the atmosphere. Mostly people have focused on trying to understand the anthropogenic components, and that is something that is extremely important as we look towards understanding what's happening in future climate. But to really understand the system as a whole, we need to understand both pieces.
The messenger spacecraft will hit the surface of Mercury and crash at the end of April. Basically, we're out of fuel now. We're at the end of a really successful mission, and what happens